Good morning, everybody. This is Kim Danke coming to you from the Shibolid Studios in Kennesaw, Georgia. Just coming to you with a little morning motivation. And I wanted to go over just a quick devotion that I found that is called Your Body is a Vessel. And I know that if you've watched any of Travis's videos over any period of time, if you've been around a long time, or if you're brand new, you'll figure this out. Travis really wants us to treat our bodies like it's the only body we're going to have. And it really is. And anything that he tries to teach you to do is for your good, for your body's good, the only body that you're going to have here on earth. And so I just thought that this was an appropriate devotion. And the verse for today is, or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. 1 Corinthians 6:19-20. So actually, when I read that, I decided to write it down, because a lot of times when I'm doing my Bible study, I write down verses because it helps to get those verses into your mind and heart in other ways than just reading them. So I remember writing that one down, but I'm going to read this to you. Some people seem to have more drive, more initiative than others. They sense their unique calling and are always ready to respond. Many of the rest of us are tired. We're worn out because we're overworked and overcommitted. A person of purpose has to have the energy to do the things they're called to do by God. And that starts with taking care of our body. When your body is exhausted, you're not going to be able to function the same. Your body is a vessel. It's a temple. The Spirit of God resides inside that temple, and it's critical that you keep that temple in good shape, not just for your own good, but for the sake of those around you and for the sake of the gospel. You're preaching a sermon with your life, after all. And if the message is always the same, overworked, worn out, poor eating habits, then perhaps others won't be as interested in what you're promoting. Maybe it's time for a change in sleeping habits, a change in eating habits, change in exercise. Perhaps it's even time for a change in perspective. Maybe you need to look at your life, your situation in a new and different way. If so, you will appreciate Marcia's story. She gave of her time, her talents, her energies in a thousand ways, never saying no to anyone or anything. As a motivated, driven woman, the word no simply wasn't in her vocabulary until she got sick. Her body began to rebel, and she found herself in bed for several days in a row, unable to function. It took some one-on-one time with the Lord and a great deal of mental anguish before she finally came to grips with the fact that the very thing that drove her motivation, her zeal, would be her undoing if she didn't take care of herself. So she changed gears. Still driven, still motivated, but now balanced. She made up her mind to only say yes to the things that God's stamp of approval was on. Sure, she said she hurt a few feelings, yes, by bowing out of things, but ultimately her health mattered more than pleasing people. Can you relate to Marcia's tale? If so, maybe it's time to reanalyze your yeses and offer a few no's. You've only got one body and need to take the best possible care of it. Balance is key. We are people of purpose. I absolutely love the balance that Shibboleth has brought into my life. I follow the shield. I live by the guidelines. I have my perfect days. I have my holidays when they're important, not just randomly. And it is balance. It's the balance that I needed. And I think that's one of the reasons that I was just so successful at it, is that I was craving that balance but didn't have the guidelines. And now I have the guidelines. So I just want to pray for you guys today that you have a wonderful day resetting your mind and your heart on treating the one body, the vessel that the Lord gave you to have here on earth, treating it well so that you can be the best that you can be for Him and everybody else. Love you guys. Have a great day.